Yon! So we have our guest speaker, si Messino. And let's start the webinar. So let's talk about Mindshift. Oh, Messino, I'll give the floor to you.
Sige. So, Mindshift, how to lose in order to win. So basically, yung intriguing dito is that I wanted to discuss the other side of trading, which is yung losing, di ba? So, isipin nyo, usually, di ba yung mga nagtuturo dyan out there, yung mga nagpapaseminar, they would really preach about yung ways on how to win. Okay? Basically, dinifocus na ganyan, yung mga setups, ganun, di ba? Isipin nyo, if there was, let's say, a speaker or a mentor at leader na nagsabi, guys, mayroon ako webinar, how to lose, tingin nyo ba? May mga sasali doon, di ba? It's something that's not really talked about. Diba sabi pa nga ng iba, may mga bashers na sinasabi nila na parang, uy, yung alagay niyo is yung mga ano, yung mga nag-google naman. Pero ito, if you actually google or mag-search ka dyan, how to lose, wala kayong masyado mapipick up content on how to lose as a trader. So, yun yan, the point of this is that I wanted to talk about that side of trading, about the losing. So, bakit? Nung isa beses kasi, when I consulted with Kidgat, mayroon siyang sinabi sa akin na statement that actually changed or shifted my mindset with regards to trading. It's this statement. There are many ways to win, but only a few ways to lose. Okay? So, I think narinig na rin ito ng mga nasa impact. So, sabi ni Cap, there are many ways to win, but only a few ways to lose. And as such, actually, onti lang yung kailangan mo tutukan in terms of how to win. Pero yung losing kasi, it's really a very specific na bagay na mangyari sa trade that you actually need to also put some focus on, put some time in order to learn how to lose. Okay? So, bakit? Okay? There are two things about losing that will really convince you that you need to know or learn how to lose. One is that losing is inevitable. Okay? Wala kang makikitang trader or mentor na magsasabi sa iyo na hindi ka matatalo sa trading, okay? You will really lose in trading. And then other point is that it will happen to you over and over and over again, okay? Diba, for example, meron kayo na aral na setup. Yung una mong iisipin, let's say when you're a newbie trader, is that meron kang search for the holy grail, diba? Naghahanap ka ng medyo kung anong setup na mataas yung hit rate. Diba? Yun muna yung hinanap mo eh. That's your concept of trading. You're searching for that setup that will give you 100% chance of success. Eventually, as you mature as a trader, may is, wala pa yung ganun. So, bababa yun. May kita mo na, ang magandang setup pala, yung mga high probability setups, minsan, they're hitting around 50 to 70%. Diba? Yung hit rate nila. And then, factor in pa, human error, human emotions. So, kahit let's say may setup ka that can win around 70% or 80% chance, if you factor in human error, bababa pa yan, lalo. It will go to around 40 to 50%, which is actually medyo elite stats na yun, di ba? Yung mga elite traders na yun, they're actually hitting around 40 to 50% hit rate with their trades. Now, paano pa tayong yung medyo mga baguhan pa sa trading? Bababa pa yun further. Ako personally, yung hit rate ko sa trading ranges from around 30 to 40%. Okay? So what does that mean? So yun ang ibig sabihin nun, madaming beses ako matatago. Kung 30% na hit rate ko, it means that I could probably lose 7 of my next 10 trades. Diba? So isip ko, kung kanilang paga, if out of 10 trades, every 10 trades, at kung beses ako mananago, so medyo madaling lang paga yung matatago. Pero yung 7 times matatago ako, I need to be able to manage that well. Diba? Gets yung point na yun. Okay? So, when I realize these two things, na, yun nga, most of the time, it will be inevitable that I will lose, at the same time, mangyayari siya, I need to shift my mind as well in order to know how to lose. So the reason why ibang traders hindi sila gumagaling is that they don't look for ways to improve the way that they lose. Okay? So a point is, as you grow and mature as a trader, the way you lose should also improve. Okay? The basis is that they're too fixated on that one trade, on each trade that they do. Na palang napakalaking bagay na matago sa isang trade. But that's not the point, okay? Each trade that you do is actually just data and you should also learn and improve as a trader. Not only in the way that you execute, journal, yung entry mo, yung selling mo, ganun. Minsan, yung cutting is also a skill. Yung sabi nga ni Kanye Kappe, di ba? Anything with ing is a skill. So, cutting, losing is actually a skill that you can improve on. Okay? At the same time, yung ibang tao kasi medyo mababaw yung context of losing sa kanila. Automatic negative yung dating. Okay? Most of the time kasi, na-mention ito ni Cap dun sa impact niya. I think impact students can relate to it. Yung minds natin kasi has this way of being defensive. Okay? Kung baga naka-safety mode yan, it's already programmed na protektahan tayo. Kaya mahirap sa atin tumanggap ng losses. At the same time, clinical studies show na alam niyo ba na financial losses have about 2.5 times the emotional impact compared to the pressure that comes from winning the same amount of money. So kunyari daw, pwede kang manalo ng 10,000 pesos. Pag natalo ka ng 10,000 pesos, mas malaki daw yung effect ng tao. So kung ganun pala yung emotional impact niya, it means that dapat maingat talaga tayo or we actually have to level up our skills in order to handle the waves. Okay? So, let's look at this quote as well. So, be willing to lose a battle in order to win the war. Okay? So, dapat ganito yung approach or mindset natin when it comes to trading. Medyo kumbaga top view or top level yung approach natin. We have to look at our trades as really a series of trades, as a series of data. Okay? And kung ganun, na dun sa data set na yun, madaming beses tayo matatago, kailangan consider tayo yun in the way that we carry out our trading, in the way that we observe our process, in the way that we learn or grow as a trader. Okay? So, how can we become a better user in trading? Okay? So, how can we take better losses? So, I'll walk you through kumbaga parang naging growth framework or growth process in order to become a better user. Okay? So, number one, okay? So, yung usual na pinakamasama in terms of cutting or not cutting losses would be this one. Yung hindi ka talaga nagbebenta at all. So, when you lose, nakita mo na negative na yung ano mo, it's ang trade mo. Negative 5, mababa pa sa further, negative 10, negative 15, hindi mo kinakut. Okay? That's the worst parang phase pa or stage that a trader can have. Okay? Included dito yung averaging down. Okay? Kasi pag nag-average down ka, you're reluctant to cut as well. Actually, nagdadagdag ka pa sa losers mo. Okay? So, yun ang very, very first stage. And as you can see, even in the social media, in the trading community, madami pa rin andito sa stage na to. So, hopefully, if you're at this stage, you move on to the next na. Okay? The next one is people who are able to cut large losses. Okay? Ito naman, yung kanina, bumabagsak pa yung di ba, mga position sila. It's going down, going down, going down. This time naman, they're able to cut na their losses. Kaso, ang problema is, ang laki na nagiging talo. Okay? So, they let it sip further down. Yung isang stage, hindi nila kaya matanggap yung talo nila. Ito, tinatanggap yung talo nila, pero at a large cost. Okay? Ang nangyari dito is that, ang effect ito is very damaged na in portfolio nila as well as their mindsets. Okay? So, again, this is the ano, parang next level na. After not being able to cut your losses or averaging down, you're now able to cut large losses. Okay? So, what's the next step? The next step is that meron ka nang yung basics of risk management. Okay? So, sapo ito would be yung negative 4% cut or yung 1-2% value at risk na cutting. Okay? So, ano yung negative 4% cut or yung mga ganitong basic risk management? Diba? Ang goal kasi nito is for capital preservation. Okay? The goal of this rule is to preserve your portfolio. Pero if you look at it, parang siya yung pinaka-basic na concept, eh, di ba? And ang dami ko yung nakita ng traders na medyo nasa-stuck dito sa level nito. Okay? So, they're always just focused on this negative 4% cutting. Kasi nga, yun yung pinaka-basic way of cutting your losses. Ang problema ko dito nakita is that, let's say, one of the trader doesn't have an edge yet. So, sige, trade siya ng trade. Kahit na nagka-cut ka ng negative 4% actually, ang nangyari dyan is that sometimes kakainin lang ng multiple cuts sa susunod na cut yung mga profits mo or yung portfolio mo. So, kahit na nagka-capital preservation ka or nagka-cut ka, dahan-dahan yung kinakain ng port mo. Okay? minsan pa nga, if you don't have proper position sizing, okay, minsan nakatalo dito. Let's say, pwedeng ang gate nga ng winner mo, tapos ang gaki ng isang position size mo, tapos pag nag-cut ka, ubos yung naging gains mo. Okay? So, this is the very basic. What traders need to understand is that compared sa ibang fields, iba yung baseline natin. Okay? Yung ibang field dyan, ang baseline or starting point natin would always be zero. Diba? Yun yung zero. Sa trading, iba eh. Pwedeng ang starting baseline mo is baon ka, hindi nga zero, negative ka pa. Okay? So, mas mahirap yung ano, laro natin.